Good afternoon to all of you. Here we will explain the chapter Biodiversity and Conservation. Biodiversity and Conservation which is the part of GS3 in our syllabus, Civil Services exam. Here we will discuss the biodiversity, the term biodiversity. The bio itself, the word showing living. And what is the mean of diversity? Diversity means variations. What type of variations you will see? Biodiversity. Bio means living and diversity means variation. Variations are of so many types. Example, genetic, species and ecological. Okay, biodiversity, it is a part of GS3 and very important part. We will see the questions asked in prelims as well. Okay, genetic variation. What is genetic variation? Genetic variation means the every human being, animal, plant, microbes having the set of gene, and they express in their own way according to the hereditary, according to the genetics. Okay, so who is our ancestor? Homo sapien. But are we same? Are we looking same to each other? No, our feature is different. Nose is different, face is different, eye color is different, hair pattern is different according to the races. If you will go to North India to South India, you will see the complexion will be dark. So that is the genetic variation. Getting? And the species variation, the number of species. If you go to equatorial rainforest, you will see the different types of plants, different types of animal. If you will go to a desert, you will see the other types of animals, like there will be the more reptiles. And again in reptiles, number of variations, that will be the species variation. What is the ecological? Ecological variation includes the biome. What is biome again? Biome having different environmental factor. Various rainfall, temperature, humidity, these are the abiotic factors in the environment. So it will be the ecological variation influences on the existence of the plants, animals, microbes. Okay, now we will see the scope of biodiversity. What is the scope? These are the points you can use in the mains. The scope of biodiversity, why it is very important, why we are conserving the biodiversity, what is the need to maintain the biodiversity, why the Biodiversity Convention Act came. So the answer is, the main role is ecological role, to balance the ecosystem. They are providing us the various services. This type of services, the medicinal, again social benefit. What is the social benefit? The social benefit of biodiversity, we can write the example of which tribe? Bisnoi tribe of the Rajasthan. They conserve their biodiversity in the forest. They protest for the sake of conservation of their forest areas. So again the economic role, food security, health security, natural fibers. What type of natural fibers we are getting? Bamboo hai, honey hai, various types of food, fruits we are getting from the forest. Again, firewood, biofuels, tourism, these are the very important for the sake of biodiversity. As well as the scientific role, aesthetic role. What is the scientific role? For the sake of studying hereditary, genetics, again the plants or animals which are going to be endangered and extinct. So we will conserve the genes by the cryopreservative techniques. We can preserve the gamete preservation. Getting? By what? How we are preserving the gamete? By the cryopreservative technique, and it involves the in situ and ex situ. We will see that also. But before that, we will going through the what is the causes of biodiversity losses. Why we need to conserve the biodiversity? Why we are taking special efforts? Because we interfere, we use, we exploit them, various plants, animals for our own purpose. When the need, there is a universe made for us to serve the services, our basic needs. But now the needs are converted to greeds, and we are doing the fragmentation of the forest areas. Fragmentation. What is the causes? Causes are fragmentation. What it means, fragmentation? A large forest area we are going to divide for the urbanization, infrastructure, construction, then what is happening? The plants, animals, trees are destroying. This is the one of the reason, and we are interfering unnecessarily in their natural habitat. What is the natural habitat? Natural habitat means their own residential house, home, unka khud ka ghar jahan hum interfere kar rahe hain, and they are getting disturbed, and again they are going to be extinct, endangered. Okay, the other is over exploitation, alien species invasion, and co-extinction. What is over exploitation? As I told you, our needs are converting into the greeds, and we are utilizing more than their services outputs. So it's going to be harmful for not only the biodiversity but total earth. It is going to be imbalanced the services. Okay, now the what is the alien services, alien species? Alien species, we bought some alien species to the India, and after that they started to hamper on our native species. So it will again the losses of biodiversity in India. The fourth is co-extinction. What is the co-extinction? Means two or four animals are depend on each other, staying with each other, and one species is suddenly died or extinct. So other three, surely they will influence on their lifespan, their living pattern. So that is the co-extinction. Here we can indirectly attach the example of scavengers. What was happened in last 10 years? Scavengers suddenly extinct hone lage, endangered hone lage, unka status kam hone laga due to that cyclophenac, which is used in the animals, cow, and they ate the scavengers, ate that cow and died, cow and buffaloes, and they died. So we need for their conservation. So whenever we need a special conservation, that is called as ex situ. Again, the conservation are of two types. Conservation are of two types, in situ, ex situ. UPSC asked this question, ex situ and in situ. I will tell you the questions also. In situ means on site, ex situ means off site. In situ is quite economically not affordable, because when we need to conserve tiger, is it possible to conserve one tiger, two tiger, 10 tigers? No, we need to conserve that total forest area. So automatically expenses will be high. We need to maintain that pura forest area, complete forest area. So this is in situ is quite not affordable, and it also criticizes the development, because no man activity can be possible in situ. You cannot go, you cannot take a food, a fuel, fruits, whatever you want to take from forest areas, you cannot go in on-site conservation. And again, off-site, when we need off-site, when the particular plant or animal is going to threaten, near threaten, extinct, endangered. So these are the again steps of plants off-site. What is off-site? The words itself saying off-site means जहाँ वो रहते हैं नेचुरल हैबिटेट में, वहाँ से उनको दूर ले जाएं एंड टेक स्पेशल मेजर्स टू कंजर्व देम, दैट इज द एक्सितु, दैट इज द एक्सितु. सो नाउ गवर्नमेंट स्टार्टेड स्कैवेंजर कंजर्वेशन प्रोग्राम. यू मे हैड सो मेनी क्रोकोडाइल, अर्लियर वी वर टाइगर, लायन. द लास्ट ईयर यूपीएससी क्वेश्चन आज द गिर नेशनल पार्क से कहाँ पे ट्रांसफर किया लायन को, एशियाटिक लायन को. दिस टाइप ऑफ वेरियस क्वेश्चन यूपीएससी आज फ्रॉम द इन्वायरमेंट. सो इन्वायरमेंट इज द बेसिक, इन्वायरमेंट इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ प्रीलिम्स एज वेल एज द मेन्स. ऑलमोस्ट अप्रोक्सीमेटली 15 to 20 क्वेश्चन केम एवरी ईयर इन प्रीलिम्स एंड प्रीलिम्स इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. यू शुड बी क्लियर. ओके, so what I told you, in situ, ex situ. So what are the in situs? In situs are the biosphere reserve, national park and sanctuaries specially for the birds. Okay, and what is ex situ? Exitus are the zoological park, botanical garden, wildlife parks. Again, I told you earlier, cryopreservative techniques for the gametes preservations. These will come under the exitu. So now, what we saw, biodiversity. The biodiversity having the life varieties. The term known as the, and it was coined by the Edward Wilson, and we saw the three types of diversity: genetic, species, as well as ecological. Later we saw the scope of biodiversity, which can be the questions in the mains, not directly but indirectly. And after that we saw the causes having fragmentation, and this question is also asked directly by the UPSC in prelims. What are the factors, what are the reasons of biodiversity losses? Okay, now we saw the conservation may again two types: on-site, off-site. On-site is known as the in situ, off-site is known as the ex situ. This is also the question asked by the UPSC. In situ mein hota hai national park, bio reserves as well as the sanctuaries, and the ex situ mein hota hai botanical garden, zoological parks, etc. In situ mein एक्सपेंसेस ज़्यादा होते हैं गवर्नमेंट के, क्योंकि दे आर कंजर्विंग नॉट ओनली द सिंगल एनिमल बट द होल फॉरेस्ट एरिया. सो नो मैन एक्टिविटी इज देयर, इट अगेन द डेवलपमेंट. सो देयर कैन बी द डिले वेदर टू प्रिजर्व द बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड एनवायरमेंट, और वी शुड गो फॉर द डेवलपमेंट, माइनिंग, वेरियस प्रोजेक्ट्स इन द फॉरेस्ट एरियाज. अगेन एक्सिटू में, एक्सिटू में क्या होता है, स्पेशल मेजर्स लेना पड़ता है पर्टिकुलर एनिमल पे या ट्री पे फोकस करते हुए. दोज वो आर गोइंग टू बी एक्सटेंट, नियर थ्रेटन, थ्रेटन और एंडेंजर्ड, दीज आर द पैरामीटर्स ऑफ अकॉर्डिंग टू द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लांट और दैट एनिमल. वी विल गो इन डिटेल आफ्टर नेक्स्ट सेशन. नाउ द कंक्लूजन ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज कंजर्वेशन इज द national responsibility of all, of not only us, who are the nations exist in the on the earth, collective and natural responsibility of all the nations. So first time kab hua tha biological diversity earth summit in the 1992, this question is also asked by the UPSC prelims. Upon the nations Rio de Janeiro mein hua tha, and after that in 2002 the World Summit Sustainable Development Goals in Johannesburg, South Africa. So what is the conclusion? Conservation of biodiversity is the responsibility of all of us, not only Indians, whoever the present on the earth, exist on the earth. We need to be conserve the biodiversity for the sake of ecological balances on the earth. Ecological balances will be directly, indirectly affect on the economical effect on the political development, will be affect on the social upliftment and development of all. So these are the points we can linked to syllabus ke pure points pe. Again the fundamental duty, fundamental duties also include the forest, environmental conservation. So you should be able to link the every point of every syllabus, like I told you, polity, social, economic, environmental, developmental, हर तरफ से हम लोग सारा पॉइंट कवर करना व्हाइल यू आर राइटिंग इन द मेंस. और प्रीलिम्स के लिए मैं आपको कुछ क्वेश्चन डिस्कस करूंगी. नाउ एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर, आई एम डिस्कसिंग द क्वेश्चन इन 2012 यूपीएससी आस्क, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी थ्रेट टू द बायोडाइवर्सिटी ऑफ जियोग्राफिकल एरिया. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी थ्रेट टू द बायोडाइवर्सिटी ऑफ जियोग्राफिकल एरिया. नंबर वन ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, नंबर टू इन्वेजन ऑफ एलियन स्पीशीज एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर हियर I wrote. Number three is fragmentation of habitat, as I told you, promotion of vegetarianism. The options are 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here is very simple. If you will go through NCERT, is very clearly now you can give the answer of these questions. Only the elimination of fourth option, that is promotion of vegetarianism, will not affect on the biodiversity. So it will be eliminate, and the answer is global warming, invasion of alien species and fragmentation. इसी से biodiversity का threat निर्माण हुआ है. Now the question is, as I told you, in situ and ex situ. In situ, ex situ में हमने देखा biosphere reserve, national park. Ex situ में हमने देखा botanical garden, zoological park. So the question is asked in 2011, which one of the following is not a site for in situ method of the conservation of flora. I told you these are the method of the conservation of the flora and fauna. Again the flora and fauna means plants and animals. So options are biosphere reserve A, B botanical garden, C national park, D wildlife sanctuary. Here biosphere reserve, national park, wildlife sanctuary are the in situ, and botanical garden is the ex situ. So you can eliminate the option 2 and you can give the answer, that is not a site he asked. So you should focus the each and every words in the question of prelims, not a site. This is the very important here. So botanical garden is the answer. Again I told you, the whenever we will go to conservation of biodiversity, we have to see the hotspot. What is the hotspot? Hotspot having the number of variation of the species as well as endemism. What is the term endemism means? Endemism means the particular species you will found only there in the world, you won't find anywhere. That is the endemism. And so question asked by UPSC is, which of the factor is responsible, which of the factors are responsible to select the hotspots. So UPSC didn't ask clearly. The question was, three of the following criteria have contributed to the recognition of the Western Ghats. Western Ghats is the hotspot of India, Sri Lanka, Indo-Burma region, hotspots of the biodiversity. And the options are species richness, number two vegetation density, number three endemism, as I told you endemism, number four ethnobotanical importance, number five threat perception, number six adoption of the flora and fauna to warm and humid condition. See here the species richness I told you, endemism I told you. When we will go to conserve, then there will be the threat. Until and unless there won't be threat, we won't conserve particular plant or animal. So these are the three options given in the answer. 1, 3, and 5, species richness, endemism and threat perception are three factors given in the 12th class NCERT of biology for the hotspots recognition by the government. So UPSC didn't ask directly the what are the factors responsible for the hotspots recognition. They asked application based question ki Western Ghats liya hai to Western Ghats mein kya kya ho sakta hai niche, which of the following is the options can be available in the Western Ghats. Theek hai, now one more question is there. Which one of the following term describe not only the physical space occupied by the organism but also its functional role in the community of the organism. As I told you, co-extinction. Co-extinction mein maine kya bola tha ki one animal ya plant ka agar extinction near danger threaten hota hai to other will be influenced by that. So that particular species is known for their functional role. not only for the physical space but also known for the functional role. That term is known as ecological niche. Habitat, already I told you, the residential address, you can say that that is a natural habitat. In the layman, you should understand the what is the natural habitat. Our particular residential address, ecological niche, not only about the physical space as well as the functional role in the particular community. And one option was ecotone. What is the ecotone? These are the two biomes. You can take any savanna and any two example you can take. Grasses or desert, or you can take the mangroves and coastal. So jo common area hota hai, that is ecotone. In this ecotone you will find number of species as well as variation, which is very important to maintain the ecology and the biodiversity. Okay, thank you.